Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Summer.
Hello, everybody. This is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Nora, are you feeling okay? You've been to the toilet 3 times this morning.
Not so well. 应该是我中午吃多了那种很辣的食物，现在肚子都开始疼了。就我的嘴巴、肚子都感觉火辣辣的，怀疑人生。
你知道，我开始还以为你嘴巴红红的是某个口红色号。Alright, anyway, have some milk or ice cream and you'll feel better soon.
Are you kidding me? Ice cream?
I'm serious. Even the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine for this year explained this.
No way. Please explain it to me in detail.
总之呢，今年的诺贝尔生物和医学奖解释啊，辣其实是一种痛觉。不是我们常识所以为的酸甜苦辣的味觉，所以呢，如果你想要不辣，就要溶解辣椒素
啊！难怪我就是说嘛，我切辣椒的时候呢，手会感觉到辣，其他地方呢也会辣，就是感觉不到甜味，
是吧？长知识了吧
？Yeah, I think so. Well, speaking of which.This year's Nobel Prize winners have just been announced recently, right?
Yeah, 每年的诺贝尔奖呢都是在10月份的样子宣布。And each prize consists of a medal, a personal diploma, and a cash award.
Prize 呢我们都知道可以表示奖项的含义啊。比如说 ,win a Nobel Prize 就是获得了诺贝尔奖。而在这里呢就可以表示奖品的含义。A thing is given as a reward to the winner of a competition.
对，那获得诺奖的奖品是什么呢？首先就是 a medal, 一枚奖牌。
Made of gold?
Yeah, of course. It was made of 23K solid gold, 23K 纯金啊。
哇。
然后第二个奖品呢，就是 a personal diploma, 一个证书。最后就是 a cash award, 现金奖励。
那 Summer, 你觉得这个奖金啊它丰不丰厚 How much do you think is the prize money?
Maybe several million? Anyway, must be a lot.
Well, according to the official figure, the prize money in total is $1.4 million. Prize 和 money 呢合起来作为一个短语就可以表示获得的奖金。那总共的现金啊其实差不多折合人民币就是700多万了。
It does sound like a huge amount of money, but winners often don't get to take home the entire prize money.
对，哎，你还真说对了。那这个奖金啊是并不能够全部带走的，这里面原因其实还挺多的。首先呢肯定就是因为要交税了。
Yeah, you got it.For example, if the laureates live in the United States, the federal government takes about 40% of their cash in taxes.
40%?
Yeah.
That's almost half of the total amount.
Yeah, you heard me. Laureate, 这个单词的发音呢，注意我们后面呢有一个 ATE, 但它读音不是吃的那个 aid, 而是发一个弱化的 schwa 的元音。Laureate, laureate.然后这个单词指的就是荣誉的获得者、获奖者和 winner 是一个含义，但这个词一般用到艺术上或者是科学上。
Yeah, so for instance, you can say a poet laureate 就是桂冠诗人啊。但如果你是把体育比赛的 winner 叫做是 laureate， 就非常奇怪了。
是的。那我们刚刚说这些 laureate 这些获奖者呢，他们40%的奖金就是用来交税。
没错，税收这里用到的单词就是 tax。如果是做名词呢，我们经常用到的短语就是 paying tax， and we are all taxpayers.
Exactly. 当然啊，除了交税，还有一个问题就是，the prize money is usually split among the winners of each prize.
Yeah, split.It means to divide something into two or more parts. 意思就是分摊、平分。就比如说男女朋友啊，如果要 AA 账单的话呢，就是 split the bill with your partner.
男女朋友 AA 还是好朋友 AA? OK, 那像2012年呢，诺贝尔和平奖就颁发给了欧盟。 那当时欧盟有27个成员国。
Wow, that's a tough question as to how to split the money.
Yeah, 这么想啊，分摊后应该就没那么多了。
对。
不过呢，对我现在来说还是不少的一笔钱了。
Exactly. Okay, then Summer, imagine that you have won the prize. How would you spend the money?
Buying a big house, I guess, and then travel around. But what did the past Loris do with the money?
这个问题啊，还真不止你一个人好奇，很多人啊，都在这个外网的 Quora 上有问过。So let's find out the answers in today's podcast. 好了，那回到我们今天的节目啊。So, of course, the typical Nobel Prize winner is no slouch.He or she has probably already got a good job at a prestigious university. But as we mentioned earlier, while winners make an honest dollar, they are not wealthy.
Hey, 对，这里面几个生词我们来看一下。第一个是 slouch， 这个单词其实经常做动词，表示你很懒散的样子。比如爸爸妈妈经常会提醒在写作业的小朋友 ，sit up straight。Don't slouch.
Right, 就是要他们挺起胸坐直，别驼背歪歪斜斜的。
对，
但是在这里啊 ，no slouch 其实是一个常见的名词短语。It means to be very good at something or quick to do something， 就是非常擅长于做某件事儿。
Exactly， 像我们形容一个人非常会赚钱啊，就可以说 he's no slouch at making a buck.
I wish I could be that kind of person.
Yeah, me too. Okay, 那回到我们刚刚那一句话，其实就是说每一个诺贝尔获奖的人呢，其实本身都很厉害啦，很有可能就已经是有名大学的教授了。
对，不过虽然他们这个奖项的钱都是辛苦赚来的，但是却没有我们想象中的那么有钱。
像这种辛苦挣来的钱啊，我们可以用到一个形容词 ,honest.这个词大家应该都知道，说一个人很诚实、
正直
对。But honest wage, 放到这个钱 wage 前面呢 ,this means amount of money that is fair for the work that is done.
Right. 那我们接下来一起来看看啊，到底获奖者是怎么使用他们的奖金的。So, most laureates spend their prize money in mundane ways. To pay the mortgage,college funds for their children, buy a car, or save for rainier days.
Oh, 所以大部分还是用到了比较普通的事情上面。Mundane, 这个单词有点像摩尔丹、蒙丹，但它其实指的是平凡的、实际的。发音的时候呢，注意我们重音是在第二个音节上 ,mundane。然后后面的元音是 a 和字母 a 读音是一样的。
Yeah, 那这些普通的事情呢，首先就包括 pay the mortgage, 意思就是还房贷，还有 pay college funds for children, 给孩子付学费。Those really are worldwide issues. 不管在哪里都是非常普遍的问题啊。
Yeah, you know, now I'm planning to buy a house next year, and it's very likely that I have to pay the mortgage monthly.
真的太难了。And it usually takes decades to pay off a mortgage, right?
对，还清贷款，动词可以用 pay off. 那一般还贷的话，都是要花几十年才能还完。所以像他们拿了奖金马上就去还房贷也是人间真实了。
没错。然后呢就还有什么买车的买船的呀。
买船、I think my boyfriend would also do that if he received that amount of money.
Well, you know, boys.、
Yeah.
But for me, I'll probably be more realistic, so I save it for rainier days.
对，反正先存起来养老嘛。
Save
for a rainy day.这个其实是一个习语啊，就是说呢，以备不时之需，未雨绸缪。
对，我记得美国历届呢，就有一任总统，他在1920年获得了诺贝尔和平奖，但那个时候呢，总统退休又没有退休金，所以他就选择存钱在银行拿利息了。但是呢，因为最后压力过大呀，他就去世了，钱也没花完。
Yet. Despite that we're talking about prize money today, I believe most of the Nobel Prize winners don't care about it that much. I mean, the more important thing for them, of course, is the research itself.
是的，其实对大部分的诺奖的获得者来说啊，这笔钱怎么花并不是一个重点哈。真正重要的是他们帮助解决了一个问题，然后帮助全社会获得了进展，这才是他们想要的。
Yeah, for that reason, some winners also chose to donate their portion of the winnings.
Donate.意思就是动词捐赠，那名词形式呢就是 donation， 我们一般会用到这个短语啊， make a donation。 那得奖主呢也真的是完全置钱财于身外物了，
是的，也非常值得钦佩呀。
Hello, welcome to Morning English。 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新，如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语，如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
好啦，那我们今天节目啊也到这里结束了。当然节目的最后呢，还是要恭喜一下所有的诺贝尔获奖者，也感谢他们为我们生活做出的贡献。
So, thank you so much for listening. This is Nora.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye.